Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. I'm Jen and Pharaby is down there. There she is. Today I wanted to talk to you about how I sleep whenever I'm having trouble sleeping because of PTSD and nightmares and all of the great things that go along with that. Okay, so one of the things I do that super helps is sleep with socks on. And you might be thinking, oh hell no, that sounds really hot. And it is kind of toasty, I'm gonna be honest, especially the first few nights you do it. If you're not a person who has like colder feet, it is a little bit toasty, but it brings comfort to you. And there's actually a thing about sleeping, putting socks on your baby when they sleep and how it helps comfort them. So it works the same for adults, even though I know that's kind of weird. But it does work the same for us grown folks as well. I'm gonna sit you guys down. I'm making coffee. Anyways, so that works. If you will sleep with socks on, even if it's like those little short jogger socks, anything at all, it still helps you sleep. So another thing you can do is journal before bed. And by journal, I just kind of mean do a brain dump. You're not trying to write any stories over here and make like a whole big, you know, to-do book. You can if you'd like to, but if you have a lot on your mind, if you will just do a simple brain dump, that is super, super helpful. I don't necessarily do a journal entry every night before bed, but if I have a lot on my mind, I do, because it just helps me to feel like, hey, I got it off my chest. I may have made a note about things I need to do for the next day, anything like that, and then it's just out of my brain. So I know I don't have to try to remember to do whatever in the morning. You can obviously do that on your phone, or you can do that like, you know, on pen and paper. The other thing I like to do before I go to bed is listen to podcasts or books. And usually what I do is I will set my timer for way longer than I think I'll need to go to sleep, because it helps you, it helps me anyway, to listen to it and actually be able to fall asleep to a story. There's obviously a lot of different things you can listen to. Podcasts are free, so that's a great option. Usually you can get a library card from your local library, and most of them have an app now, and you can listen to books for free on there. You usually have them for like 14 days, 10 days, something like that. So it's not a lifetime, but you know, it's long enough for you to listen to it. Also there's apps if you want to pay for something like Calm. I know they have bedtime stories that are meant for like grown people. There's also an app, it's called Headspace. They have bedtime stories on there as well. So there's a lot of different ways to listen to bedtime stories. It doesn't have to be meant for bedtime. It can be anything you're interested in at all, but that helps me so much. That is, if I had to say number one takeaway tip from this whole entire thing, is listen to stories before you go to sleep, because it gets your mind on something else other than your troubles. And if you have, you know, if it's like a story, like a children's story or like a bedtime story, they're usually very vivid in detail. And so you can actually get a visual of what they're telling you. And I know the ones for Headspace, they have some breathing exercises built in. So you're not only listening to just a story, you're also, you know, they're like, take six deep breaths or whatever, you know, and it has that randomly in there. And so, you know, as long as you follow along, it's really, really helpful. The last thing I like to do before I go to sleep is probably controversial a little bit, because people say to stay away from blue light before you go to sleep. But for me, I don't know, I guess that doesn't matter as much, probably should, but I like to do puzzles on my iPad or either color on my iPad. You could do this on your phone too. There's some really good, easy to do like coloring things if you have to do it on your phone. Sandbox is one of them. There are a lot of them, they're like pixel colors. So it's just little pixels and you actually just hit the little dot, and it's super repetitive, but it's relaxing. And for me, doing that, it helps me to go to sleep. So I will put on a podcast or like a bedtime story thing, and then I will color or either do puzzles on my iPad until I get sleepy. You're not thinking about the game really, that's kind of just on autopilot, so that you're not able to think about other bad stuff, and then you're listening to your podcast or your book or whatever. And so it's like keeping you super busy in a calm kind of way. And then guess what happens? You get sleepy, and then you go to bed and you go to sleep. And it's really, really nice. So those are my tips. So I would say if you take anything away from this, try the socks, try putting socks on, and also try listening to a story. Like if you don't try anything else that I've told you today, try those two things if you haven't already, because for me, that is like game changer. Where'd my dog go? For me, that's like game changer, like super, super helpful. You know, to try to sleep. And I'm a person who has really bad nightmares and stuff. And sometimes I struggle with sleep. Sometimes I sleep a ton. So it's very inconsistent with me, I guess we'll say. Obviously this is not gonna fix like true sleep disorders, but this is for people who have trouble falling asleep because they have a lot on their mind or they're going through something really bad. It helps to like clear your brain and just kind of, you know, make you feel a little bit more at peace. So I hope this is helpful for you guys. Leave a comment. Let me know if you do anything to help yourself sleep. Let me know if you feel like you've tried these tips. They do work for you. And I will see you guys soon. Bye, guys.